Good morning, everybody. This is Nate over at Bullion RV in windy Duluth, Minnesota. So I have another video for you today. I just covered this video a little bit or a couple days ago, but the audio got corrupted. So sorry for the delay in videos, but I have that 24 Flagstaff Classic 361 RL. We're gonna go over the outside features, inside features, and let me know what you think in the comments down below. Make sure you like, follow, subscribe, all the fun stuff. Help Bullion get to 20,000 subscribers on YouTube. Without further ado, let's get started. And this is a fifth wheel, so all the dimensions, all the specs are going to pop up almost instantaneously here off to the left. So we'll take a look at the front cap. There's that light bar that goes across. Our Rotoflex. You do have your disconnect, and then you do have your battery in here. I've seen this used for storage as well. Off to the left, you do have a little light. Coming over to the right, solar on the side, docking lights here. I'm gonna take a step back so we could see the side. So this does have three slides. Two opposing in the living room, one in the bedroom, with slide toppers, as you can see up here. Two 20-pound propane tanks that we do fill upon purchase. Going over to the right. Large pass-through storage. So you have storage for those stools there. Every Flagstaff will come with a grill and a grill attachment, which I'll cover on the other side. You do have your outdoor shower attachments here, and then you do have electronic leveling, which we'll take a look at underneath here. So enclosed underbelly, and then I'll have to go a little bit further down, but it's good that we're seeing this now. Here's our hookups here, winterize, everything that you need to do. Here's our furnace. Low point drain, gray water holding tank, sewer outlet connection. Dual axle. So I'm gonna come over to the right. So you do have your ice maker valve here as well. My key can't fit this lock right now, but that will be taken care of. So there's that electronic leveling that I was talking about in the rear. And then behind that, you can see the spare tire. And off to the right in the very back here, you do have a little bit of storage area here. I know there's going to be some comments saying, well, what can that store? What does that have to do with anything? But, you know, I've seen first aid kits. I've seen, you know, kitchen supplies. Even though this doesn't have an outdoor kitchen, I've seen a lot of use for this storage here. So, yeah, it's all a matter of being creative, but I kind of like this space. Here's for our fresh water drain. And you're gonna hear the cars behind me, I'm sorry. You do have a 50 amp service here, right there. Ladder to get up on the roof. And this is prepped for a backup camera. With towing package here. I'm gonna hover over here. I don't know if we can see that. Feel free to pause the video here. Hopefully we can get a little bit more information here for us. Probably not, but we're trying. Coming over here, we're gonna see another slide here, but I'm gonna back up so we can see that. Again, these do have slide toppers. This is that other slide for the living room. Again, just beautiful, beautiful product here. I really like the way the sun is catching this right now. So I mentioned on the pass-through storage that you do have a grill attachment, and that sits right here. And you do have multiple different awnings here as well, with the LED light strip down below, which I really, really like. You do have your GFCI outlets here. Now I wanted to cover these steps here too. Again, another awning, that LED light strip. I wanted to cover these steps because they're not gonna fight you. So I can just easily pop it up there, and you can see it's just held in place, but they're not gonna fight you on the way down.
So again, just one hand. Sorry for the noise. But again, I cover this in all of my Flagstaff videos. The Flagstaff difference, the superior construction, the build quality, everything's labeled here, so you know you're getting a quality piece. So I'm gonna hover over everything here. Feel free to pause the video for a little bit more information.
All right, with the outside covered, let's head on to the inside, cover some features there. And again, just let me know what you think in the comments down below. I mentioned before, I'm still fairly new to RVs, but I think I'm getting better every day.
So let's head inside. This is your grab handle. This comes out and comes down. So you do have one to get in. Right off to the left, you do have your fire extinguisher. Then stepping in, I'm gonna pan all the way around. Opposing slide. And opposing slide really opens up the room. Very nice family fifth wheel. So coming over here to the kitchen area. So you do have your two chairs, and then you did see those two stools in the pass-through storage. So if you want to have a little bit more company here, or even at the center island, you do have that. Lots of windows through here as well to let in that natural light. Lots of lights throughout here, come to think of it. Ceiling fan. Very nice lights above the center island. This does have two ACs as well, which I'll show you the second one in a moment. Millsburg Collection seating, very comfortable chairs. And another thing I wanted to cover here in the windows, so you can see shade number one, and you do have shade number two. Very nice to have there, and that goes throughout. So coming into some of the storage here, but first we got some GFCI outlets and charging outlets for your devices. Your Millsburg Collection couch, which folds down into a bed. Hard to do that with one hand on the GoPro. Same charging outlets on the opposite side. Storage up above. And then I'm gonna open up all of these because it's one solid cabinet that goes all the way through. So you can kind of see that we go all the way down. And then coming out. Right up above, we do have one of our vents. I'm panning over to the right here, so you do have an exit window. And then you do have your entertainment area. So if I'm sitting in the chairs here, I got a view of my fireplace, I got a view of my TV, and off to the right is your kitchen here. Very comfortable chairs. There's that fireplace. TV with lots of counter space here too. Storage up above that TV. More storage up above that TV. A little bit of storage below the TV. And then solar on board here, solar instructions here. Then storage on the inside. QR code here for owner information, which I really think comes in handy. Here's the microwave right at eye level. Three burner cooktop with your oven here. Moving into the kitchen, lots of storage here. Plenty of storage coming down. Coming around to the center island. Plenty of storage to work with there. You do have owner's manual and all information on this fifth wheel here. We do have our fridge freezer. Pardon the noises. Lots to work with here. And we do have a freezer down below. All right, so I'll get one view of that fridge. Kitchen area one more time. living room. Coming over to the last portion of the kitchen here. I'm gonna go over some of the storage, work our way up. There's our garbage can there. A little bit more storage for cleaning supplies, whatever you might need. Silverware holder, whatever you might need that for here. Storage down below. And more equipment for the camper, also storage here as well. So moving up, some of the interior features. Again, I'm gonna highlight this here as well. Feel free to pause the video again and just get a little bit more knowledge. That pink is winterized fluid. We do winterize all of our fifth wheels and all of our campers that come in. Now that we got that done, we'll take a look at the storage up above here. Plenty of room to work with. You do have a little charging device outlet there. A little storage underneath. Lots of room to work with. So we've covered the living room, the kitchen. Now let's get into the bathroom and the bedroom. And again, just let me know what you think in the comments below. Coming up the stairs here, you're gonna have your command center for your lights, your slides, your awning, tank heaters, everything, you name it. You're gonna have your furnace controls here too as well. And then since you do have solar, your solar controller is gonna be right here. So moving on up, taking a left into the bathroom. There's our toilet there. Towel holder here. A little bit darker, but these are very deep storage pockets. You can see the end here. So a lot of times what I see is folks fold up towels and kind of stack them throughout. Washcloths, you name it. Then you're gonna have the same down below. Shower with a seat here. We'll take a look at that. Skylight letting that natural light in. And coming over here, a little bit of storage underneath the sink here. Bathroom cleaning supplies, anything you might need. There's our sink. I still think plenty of counter space. GFCI outlets. All of our controls are going to be in here as well. Little mini storage here. And then in our medicine cabinet. All right, that's the bathroom. Actually, before I move on, here's our fan. That's the bathroom. Moving on into the bedroom. First thing you'll notice off to the right is an exit window. And then coming up, there's that second AC I mentioned. All right, there's the bedroom. So first thing I want to cover, doing this with one hand isn't the greatest. Tons of storage underneath the bed, lots to work with. So I'm gonna set this down here. So if you hear a loud bang, I apologize. Not as loud as I thought, but moving on. You could see off to the left there, you do have charging outlets there. And off to the right, you do have those same charging outlets there. Turning behind me here before we get into the closet, you do have your dresser with our TV. Lots of room up here on the counter. Deeper storage pockets in the bedroom here. I'm saying pockets, but I should say drawers. That's on. So you'll see our closet here, lots to work with.
This does have a sliding door, but I'll sit on the bed and kind of pan throughout the closet here. You got GFCI outlets in this closet, and obviously my personal favorite, you do have washer and dryer prep sitting back there as well. So it's a little bit darker, but this has everything that a family could possibly be looking for. And then off to the left here, you'll see another storage pocket through the cabinets here, which I'll open up now. These are all one cabinet. But there you have your pull for clothes if you wanted to take this out. And if I didn't open these up again, we'll take a look. This fifth wheel just has a lot to offer for a family or even family and friends. You have a lot of room to walk around. Nobody's gonna be bumping into each other. I know that this is a little bit longer of a video, but I really do like the Flagstaff product. So I'm just coming down the stairs now. So we'll take another look at this living room. Again, opposing slides really opens this up and it makes it a nice space for everyone. And again, it's not those lights, whites, grays, and blacks. It's got a lot of different colors to it that you have to be in here to see, to feel, and really get that, that feeling of the Flagstaff product. So, but enough of my talking. That's gonna be it on this video. My name is Nate Green from Bullion RV in Duluth, Minnesota. All my information is gonna be in the description box below. If you wanna set up an appointment to meet with me, definitely feel free to call me at 218-740-4965. Make sure you like the video, comment, subscribe, help us get to 20K subscribers, and I'll see you all in the next one. Thanks for watching, have a great day.